Dear students, in this lecture we will discuss power flow and losses in DC machines. For any machine, we know that efficiency can be written as output power upon input power into 100%. For any machine. Like in transformer, but that was a static machine, no moving part was there. So for any machine, formula is same. The same can be written as output power upon output power plus losses. Input power is nothing but output power plus losses into 100%. So we will discuss, first we will discuss the various losses in DC machine, and then we will discuss about power flow in DC machine. So just write down losses in DC machine. Machines. So these losses are remember losses of transformer, you might be remembering core loss or iron loss, copper loss, like that. Those losses will be here. Apart from those losses, because of the moving part, some other losses are also there. So we are going to discuss one by one. So first write down copper loss. Copper loss, that is I square R loss. So wherever windings are there, corresponding resistances are there, if current I flows, then I square R loss will be there. So we have two windings, one is armature winding, another is field winding. So corresponding to these two windings, two currents are there. In field winding, field current is there, armature winding, armature current is there, and hence corresponding copper losses will be there. So this copper loss can further be categorize into two categories: armature copper loss, that is armature current is IA, and we represented armature resistance by RA, so this loss will be represented by this IA square RA loss. Then another one will be, let us write here itself, field copper loss. So if we represent field current by IF and field resistance by RF, then this loss will be represented by IF square RF loss. So copper loss, we have brush loss. Brush losses, just write down losses, right? So we know that armature current passes through the brushes, IA, armature current IA in DC machine passes through the brushes, and brushes are also having some finite value of resistances. So some drop will be there, brush voltage drop, so corresponding losses will be there, right? So this loss is given by VBD into IA, where IA is armature current and VBD is brush voltage drop. This is brush voltage. This is known as brush voltage drop. Generally ignored, if not given in problem or not stated, then by default we are ignoring it, right? Sometimes the value might be given, take brush drop as 2 volt. So armature current is known, so you can calculate, right? Near about 2 volt we are going to assume. If brush drop per brush is given, so corresponding to two brushes, we may get the total brush drop around 2 volt. 1.5 volt like that, right? So this will be VVD into IA, brush voltage drop. So next, core loss occurring in core. So core losses are further categorized into eddy current losses, you know it, eddy current losses and hysteresis losses. So eddy current losses, I am not going to explain in detail again and again, because you are aware of, well aware of these quantities, these eddy current losses and hysteresis losses, as you have studied your transformer and induction part of the machine. So remember, either in case of transformer or induction machine, we have frequency F. So in case of eddy current losses, represent PE, represented by PE and represented by this PH. So remember, PE was proportional to maximum flux density square times F square. But here the armature current is armature current across terminal. We are talking about load current, armature supply current or output current, that is DC. Though current wave shape in a part in conductors, armature conductors, before the brushes are alternating nature, but after brushes, when we are collecting, we are getting of DC nature having frequency zero. So this is not appropriate to write here like this. But we know that N is equal to 120 F by P. So we may write these are constant quantity, that is F is proportional to F. So instead of F, we will write here, this PE is proportional to B max X square times N square. Similarly, PH is proportional to B max, here one exponent was there, that was N, known as Estimate exponent, having value between 1.5 to 2.5, right? I think you remember it. So BM or F was there, so instead of F, we will write N here. Hope it is clear to you. Now the third type of loss is mechanical losses. Right here, mechanical losses. Losses, also known as friction and windage losses. So these are having two components, friction losses and windage losses. So because of friction occurring, we have moving part, rotating parts, so friction occurs between two quantities, one stationary, one rotating. For example, bearings, brushes, we know that brushes touch the commutator segments and commutator segments are rotating parts, brushes are stationary parts, so friction will be there, so corresponding losses will be there. So we can categorize these friction losses into two categories, in bearings and in brushes. So this loss is proportional to N, speed of the motor. This loss is proportional to N square of the speed of the motor. Fine. Windage losses. Windage losses occur because of the opposition offered by the surrounding airs surrounding to the moving part, right? Once rotor rotates, so the air in its surrounding opposes the rotation. That's why some losses are there. That is known as windage losses. So mechanical losses together, we can say mechanical losses or friction and windage losses. These two losses together, core losses and mechanical losses, are known as rotational losses. Rotational losses. So remember the terms carefully, because sometimes in problem this term might be used or some other terms like that, right? One last right here, stray losses or miscellaneous losses. So what are stray losses? All those small losses, or whatever is small or more, all losses not considered so far under these losses are known as stray losses. Sometimes in problem only copper loss will be given and other losses known as stray losses are these. Sometimes it might be given. So it means stray losses means miscellaneous losses, as we use generally our expenditure, this much here, this much here, and remaining is miscellaneous. So whatever is left, that comes under miscellaneous losses, that is stray losses. If we have taken all these together under miscellaneous losses, so that's no problem. Fine. Generally, brush losses being small and remaining other losses being small are ignored by default. Unless stated in the problem, don't worry about that. Whatever data is given, just use those data in calculation. Don't search unnecessary some stray losses or like that. If these values are not given in the problem directly or indirectly, it means by default these small losses have been assumed as zero, neglected. Fine. So this windage loss is proportional to n cube. Now we will discuss the power flow in DC machines. So far we have discussed losses in DC machines. Now we will discuss power flow in DC machines. So first we will discuss for motor, DC motor, then we will discuss for DC generator. So what do we mean by power flow? We have input power, we have output power, and we have losses in between. So various stages will be like this. First write for DC motor. So in DC motor we have input power P in, we have terminal voltage VT and line current IL. So this power will be terminal voltage times line current, input power. So that power enters into the machine, current enters through the brushes, so brush losses will be there. So subtract that loss. So after subtracting brush loss, the remaining input power VTIL minus brush losses, which will be VBD times IA, the remaining will be the difference of these two. Then corresponding to the two windings, armature winding and field winding, copper losses will be there. So subtract those losses, and write here copper losses, right? Copper losses then the remaining power will be developed power, power developed by the DC motor. See, total input power VTIL enters, subtract this brush losses, again subtract copper losses, then remaining power will be developed power, and this power is given by EB back EMF into IA. This is can further be written as torque into omega. As we know, power is equal to torque into omega. This is developed power, we will discuss later in detail. Then after this, subtract one more loss, core losses. From the developed power, core losses will be subtracted. Then again, subtract friction and windage losses, known as mechanical losses. And these two losses, as discussed earlier, together known as rotational losses. So the remaining power, again, if given, then subtract stray losses, miscellaneous losses, and the remaining power, after subtracting this stray losses, the remaining power will be output power, shaft power, output power. So this is power flow diagram of DC motor. This is input power, that is output power. In between, the various stages are shown. These are the losses, various losses. If given in problem, we will consider. If ignored, that's good. Our calculation will be simple, right? This is developed power. What about in case of generator? So we know that the power reverses. In case of generator, in case of motor, we have electrical power input, mechanical power output. In case of generator, we have mechanical power input and electrical power output. In between, losses will be there. So in case you want to draw for DC generator, just reverse the directions of this, right? Okay, let us draw here itself. So right here, DC generator. For DC generator, so input power will be PSH, input power, here write down, shaft power, input power, this is input power, right? For motor, so here for generator, mechanical, shaft power will be input power, then subtract spray losses. Then the remaining power, subtract mechanical losses. Mechanical losses, then subtract core losses. Then remaining power will be develop power. So this will be EMF generated E into armature current II, that is tau omega, right? In case of motor, we are represented by back EMF. So induced EMF is E. We are talking about motor generator now, DC generator. So after this, what is next stage? So subtract copper losses. Then from remaining power, subtract brush losses. And whatever the power is there, that is the output power. P out, output power. So these are the various stages in case of DC generator, right? So what will be output power? Here we have written VTIL, so similar to that, terminal voltage. In case of generator, we have our terminal voltage magnitude lesser than this EMF induced, right? So we will write VTIL. Fine. Now come to the power developed in DC motor. This is PD and we represented it by EBIA. So let us discuss this power developed and the condition so that we can get the maximum power developed in DC motor. So let us take example of any motor, say separately excited. So this is separately excited motor. This is back EMF here, armature resistance, brushes, and terminal voltage VT is there, right? Plus minus. So this is line current IL. This will be same as IA in case of separately excited. Let us make equivalent circuit. So this is EB. So this is plus minus VT. This is armature resistance RA plus minus, and this is IL, and this is same as IA, right? Armature and line current are same. Fine. So remember our KVL equation. We have VT is equal to, in case of DC motor, IARA plus EB, that is EB plus IARA. If you want to take, consider the brush voltage drop, so you may write here itself, brush voltage drop. Multiply both sides with armature current IA. So we will write here VTIA is equal to EBIA plus IA square RA plus VBD IA. As discussed earlier, brush voltage drop will be VBD IA, right? Copper loss will be IA square RA. One more loss will be there in the field, right? We are ignoring that loss for time being. So if we are going to ignore this loss also, so focus on these two. So this is input power, input voltage, input current, IL is IA. This is EB, back EMF, IA. This is developed power, PD. This is known as PD, and remaining is losses. So whatever input power is there, subtract losses, so remaining will be developed power. So if you want to get maximum PD, you want to maximize PD. So first write PD is equal to EBIA is equal to, what is EB? EB will be VT minus IARA. VT minus IARA times IA. So this will be VTIA minus IA square RA. That is input power minus copper loss. Other losses have been ignored here. So for maximum develop power, we will write dpd upon dia, variable is load current, armature current ia, that is the same as load line current, is equal to 0. This implies we are going to differentiate with respect to ia. So this will be vt minus 2iara is equal to 0. This implies iara is come, this drop is coming out to be vt by 2. What does it mean? The drop across this will be equal to half of this. So remaining half will be across this. Or from here, we may write Eb is equal to Vt minus IRA. And Vt is coming out to be corresponding to maximum power developed. So Vt is coming out to be 2 IRA, or IRA is coming out to be Vt by 2. Represent in any one term. Okay, Vt minus IRA is Vt by 2. So this is coming out to be Vt by 2. It means condition for maximum power developed is that whatever input voltage you have, voltage drop, half of this will appear across the armature terminals and half of this will appear across these terminals, right? Back EMF. It means armature terminal drop will be equal to back EMF. Eb will be equal to IARA. Eb is Vt by 2 and Vt by 2 is IARA. So you may write is equal to IARA. But huge loss will take place. Let us calculate that loss. So that loss, percentage of loss may be evaluated by evaluating efficiency. So let us evaluate efficiency corresponding to maximum power developed. Efficiency corresponding to PD. So that will be output power. So output power will be this EBIA. So EBIA upon EBIA, or directly write input power. EBIA plus losses. Most of the losses have been ignored. So directly write input power. VT IA into 100%. This will be the efficiency corresponding to maximum power developed. Substitute the values. So EB is coming out to be VT by 2 or any other value, IARA. You may write IARA, right? So this is EB is coming out to be IARA. So write down IARA times IA upon VT. So again, VT is coming out to be 2IARA, twice of IARA times IA, this IA, right? So we can see that into 100%. So this is coming out to be IA square RA upon 2IA square RA into 100%. So this will get cancelled with this. So 100 by 2, this is coming out to be 50%. See, 50% power is lost. So if you want the power developed to be maximum, beyond that it is not possible to have. So total of 50% at max, even though we have ignored some other losses like IF current will be there, RF field resistance is there. So IF square RS will be there. That would be considered. That is also VF if this is plus minus VF. So that is also input power. That will also contribute to this power. Whatever total input power is being fed to the machine, whatever power we are getting, we have taken as output. So whatever power we are providing to the machine, electrical power, that should be considered. We have ignored, even though we can't get more than this. It means we will get our efficiency lesser than this. Clear? So for this is one of the condition that EB should be equal to VT by 2 or IRA. Condition for maximum power developed is EB is equal to VT by 2 or is equal to IARA. Suppose this is condition A. We know that EB is nothing but K phi N omega, whatever you want. In separately excited DC motor, phi is also constant. So you may write K dash some other constant times N. That is, in separately excited DC motor, this is proportional to N. And this gives one fixed value of back EMF. It means this condition gives indirectly a fixed value of speed. What does it mean? There exists a particular speed at which the developed power will be maximum. Hope it is clear to you. Let us solve one problem on efficiency. This problem was asked in GATE 2016. It says that a DC shunt generator delivers 45 ampere at a terminal voltage of this. The armature and shunt field resistances are this and this, armature and shunt respectively. The stray losses are 375 watt. The percentage efficiency of DC generator is. So first make one generator so that it will be easy for us to understand the problem. So this is DC generator, EMF induced, and let us represent RA. DC shunt, so shunt field winding will be there. And this is terminal voltage, output terminal voltage, VT. And IL, this is field current IF, this is RF, and this is armature current, right? So right here IA, fine. So if you want to make equivalent circuit, so that will be EB, then RA and IA, same, right? IF, RF, this is IA, this is IL, this is VT. This is the equivalent circuit diagram for our DC shunt generator. So delivers, IL is equal to delivers, right? 45 ampere at terminal voltage of 220 volt. So this is given as 45 ampere. This is given as 220 volt. The armature and shunt resistances are, armature resistance is given as 0.01 ohm. And shunt resistance is this, is given as 44 ohm. Fine. The stray losses are, see here, we know armature resistance, we know field resistance. So the two copper losses may be evaluated, IA square RA plus IF square RF. Other losses has not been given separately, but it has given that the stray losses, that is miscellaneous losses, as we discussed earlier. Try to understand the terminology. So the stray losses, miscellaneous losses are, all losses are given together. That is 375 watt. So we can evaluate copper losses and the other losses are given together. No need to worry. Directly we can add total losses and we have to find out the efficiency of generator. So we know that efficiency will be P out upon P in, and P in will be nothing but P out plus losses, total losses, into 100%. So first find out P out. So P out will be VT into IL. So this is coming out to be 220 into 45. Now total losses, stray losses are 375. What about copper losses? So total copper losses PCU will be equal to IA square RA plus IF square RF. So we have the values of RA and RF, but we don't have the direct values of IA and IF. We need to evaluate it. So IF will be nothing but this voltage drop upon this resistance. So IF may be written as, this is 220 drop across this field winding and resistance is 44 ohm. So this is coming out to be 5, right? 5 ampere. So this we have calculated 5 ampere. So apply KCL here. So whatever armature current is there, we know it. IA is nothing but equal to IL plus IF. So 45 plus, that's why we will write IA is equal to 45 IL plus IF, that is 45 ampere plus 5 ampere, that is coming out to be 50 ampere. Now substitute the values. So IA is 50 ampere. So 50 square times RA is 0.01 plus IF is, we have calculated 5, and RF is 44. So this is coming out to be 0 square will get cancelled, 25, right? Right, 5 into 5, 100 will get cancelled it, right? Plus 25 into 44. So this is coming out to be 1100, right? 25 for the 100 and 1000, 1100. That is 1125 watt. So total losses will be, write down losses or total losses, will be equal to, therefore total losses will be equal to stray losses, miscellaneous losses 375 plus copper losses 1125. So this is coming out to be 1500. Now we have all values, so substitute here. So this will be, output power is coming out to be 220 into 45 upon output, same 220 into 45 plus total losses 1500 into 100%. Calculate it. In my calculation, it is coming out to be 86.842%. Just check it yourself, right?